being disturbed. People ask me, Swamiji, an enlightened person should not have a desire. You really don't have a desire? They come and ask me. I tell them, be very clear. Enlightened person, the word enlightenment should be very clearly understood. Only then you will understand the enlightened person also. See, as on now, in a normal human mind, if they have 10 acre, all 10 acre, they are growing something, some rice or paddy or sugar cane or something. It is filled, occupied. In an enlightened being, he has got 1 million acre, only 10 acre is used for agriculture. Will he even know that agriculture is going on in some place? No. I have million acre. So even if agriculture is going on in 10 acre, I will not even know. Same way, enlightened being has got so much of inner space, the 10 acre is like a negligible. The inner chattering which is happening is negligible. All you need to do is expand the inner space. I am not telling you to kill all the, destroy the agriculture which is happening in 10 acre. No. That will lead you to tamas, means depression and inertia. That will lead you to tamas and depression. I am not telling you to destroy the agriculture which is happening in the 10 acre. No, I am telling you to expand the inner space so that the 10 acre sound will not disturb you. The noise which is being created in the 10 acre agriculture will not disturb you. You will not feel suffocated. You will have more space. You will feel expanded. You will feel the fulfillment. Aparigraha does not mean not having the basic items, basic things, no. But creating a bigger inner space. How to? How to do? Whenever you feel that you are possessing something, decide very clearly to unclutch from it consciously. Visualize how your life will be without that object or that person. Sometimes you may think, oh, I can do without it. That's all. Then perfectly all right. Sometime you may have little suffering. Go through that suffering, that moment itself. That suffering itself will purify you. Understand? When you feel that you are too much attached, you are possessive of some person or some object, sit and visualize your life without that person or that object. If you feel you can do without it, relax, nothing to worry. If you feel suffering, oh God, my life will, I can't do without him or her or that object, then sit and meditate your life without that person. Create that pain. Let allow that suffering. Suddenly you will see that suffering itself is so powerful. The pain is so powerful. It will teach you. It will purify you. When you come out, when that suffering disappears from your inner space, because you can't be constantly suffering. At the most, you can suffer for a few hours. Slowly that suffering will settle down. That depression will leave you. That pain will leave your inner space. When that pain leaves your inner space, already you would have learnt a lesson of aparigraha. This is powerful technique to achieve aparigraha. Start meditating your life without that person or object. Let that pain, suffering arise in your inner space. And wait till it disappears. Be silent. Have patience till that disappears. when that pain and suffering leaves your inner space, you would have been matured, because pain and suffering teaches you. It's a powerful master. It's a powerful teacher. No other master or teacher can teach you like pain or suffering. Using even pain to learn, using even suffering to grow, using even the failures to mature yourself. When you expand your inner space through this way, understand this technique is a very powerful technique. Try it. Whenever you feel you are possessive of somebody, something, sit, unclutch, disconnect, allow the pain, allow the suffering. Now what can be done? Because anything can be taken away from you. The product or that person can be taken away from you. It is not that he or that person is, that person or the product is going to be with you forever. No. So, just meditate. The non-possessiveness. Meditate on aparigraha and be without that person or the object. You will see the pain itself teaches you, and you are free from the pain, you are free from the suffering, you are free from the parigraha, you are free from the possessiveness.